Michaela reminded me that I need to put one up. So thank you, Michaela, this is for you. Today I'm going to show you three different ways to get into the spatchcock. Everybody's body is different, so try all three ways. Okay, so one thing you have to remember about the flexibility for the spatchcock is it's not a full middle split. So when you practice it, practice with your legs a little bit in front of you, not straight out to the side, but a little bit in front of you. The next thing you want to do is worry about trying to get your belly button to the floor. Okay, so this is your stretch for the spatchcock. If you want to make that a little bit more intense, you can take the blocks, put the legs up on the blocks, and then go ahead and take it forward, and again, try to get that belly button to the floor. All right, the other thing that I find is really helpful for spatchcock, flexibility and active flexibility, is to come to the pole, get into a shoulder mount position with the hand in an eagle or twisted grip, and see if you can get the top leg down low to your elbow. So this is a really good stretch for this. And also, see if you can do it without helping. Okay. So the first way I'd like to show you how to get into spatchcock is from a twisted grip. All right? You really want to make sure that the leg comes down at about elbow height rather than really high at wrist height on the pole. The reason for this is you're going to have to be a lot more flexible the higher the top leg is. You really want to be making a triangle position on the pole, not flat pancaked against the pole. Okay, so from a twisted grip, when you try to bring the top ankle onto the pole. So here we go.